My classroom this year is very different than classrooms in the past. I've moved everything to be more student-centered as opposed to teacher-centered, and that's because I've tried to make my learning more personalized. So in the past, I would be lecturing and the class would be completely silent, and my students would a lot of times be bored, and that was a struggle for both of us because I would be bored as well.
I feel like if a teacher's like in front of the class, I feel like I don't learn as much because she's kind of like talking to a bunch of other people and not just me.
When you do it all as a class, you usually have to ask so many questions, or then like you have to just pay attention for so long, and like sometimes you could just get zoned out so you just don't pay attention anymore.
I had never thought about what I could do differently because I was always worried about how could I fit the most content into my course as possible. I knew that something needed to change, and I just had to figure out what that was. Moving toward a flipped classroom was a very different procedure than I've used before in my class. In a traditional classroom, if you walked in, there would probably be a teacher at the board presenting a lesson, and then as soon as the lesson was over, the teacher would give the students homework to do, and the kids would take the homework home and hopefully do their homework, and then bring it back the next day, and you kind of rinse, lather, repeat type this process every day. So with the flipped classroom, I've taken my lessons that were 30-minute long lectures and I've changed them into 5 to 10-minute videos. They're able to rewatch a video of a topic that they're stuck on, or if they go home and their parents want to help them, a parent is able to watch the video. It basically provides my math lessons on demand for my students. It's like Netflix for math.
But what that looks like is we have a lot of kids that are working in small group. We have kids working in pairs. We have kids working by themselves, but they're going at their own pace, which is pretty cool for them.
It gives you more independence. Everybody's not gonna always be there to help you. Sometimes you gotta learn on your own. So it does make sense to start early.
You know, the students take ownership of their learning, and that's the biggest key. Is they are responsible for staying on track. They know their weekly goals, where they need to be, and it's on them to say, you know, I'm ready to take a quiz, I'm ready to take a test.
No longer have test days in my classroom. Pretty much every day is a test day because my students get to decide when they are ready to take a test. So in the past, my first quiz in my class is usually around 60 or 70% passing, whereas in this new process, I've gotten it up to 100%. But the great thing about this style of teaching is it gives me even more time to talk to my students. I have more time to work one-on-one with students and answer their questions as soon as they have them.
She reaches all kids on different levels. Some of the kids are down here, some of the kids are in the middle, some of the kids are up here, but she makes sure that we're all on the same level because she understands us.
Because of the strong relationships I've made with my students, I believe they are more willing to go outside of their comfort zone and they're willing to learn math in a way that they may have never learned before. My students have become better learners because of this process.